هيا على الفلاح.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask him every goodness. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the best of this world and the next. We ask him to grant cure to those who are sick and ill. And we ask him to have mercy upon those who've passed on. And we ask him to have mercy upon us the day he takes us away too. Ameen. My beloved brothers, my sisters, this evening in Salat al-Taraweeh, we heard verses of Surat al-Furqan. Across the globe, different masajid and different venues of Taraweeh move at different paces and they read different parts of the Quran. So this evening, the 19th part of the Quran and the end of the 18th, the chapter known as Al-Furqan or the Criterion, I'd like to pick up from this beautiful surah a few lessons that we could learn. These lessons are directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He tells us about what will be happening on the day of judgment, and he tells us what will be the issues that people will regret. Now, before we go into this, in our lives, there are so many things we want to get done. We'd like to perhaps earn, we'd like to buy maybe a house or a car or good food or nice clothing or beautiful accessories. We have a dream of getting married if we're not, and if we are, a dream of having children, and if we have the children, a dream of them one day perhaps getting, you know, graduating, getting married, having their own children. So you ask Allah, oh Allah, keep me alive for as long as I have children. And then when you get children, oh Allah, I'd like to see them getting married. Then when they get married, oh Allah, I'd like to see them having children. I want to be a grandfather or a grandmother. And then when they are there and Allah blesses you with that, you say, oh Allah, let me see my grandchildren getting married. And when they are married, we then say, oh Allah, let me see my grandchildren have children so that I can be a great grandfather or mother. It never stops. So Allah says, you know what? While you are thinking about all of what you want on earth, remember, there will be certain things you will regret when you come on the day of judgment. One of the things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about very loud and clear is the distance between us and the revelation. When there is a distance between us and the Quran, we will regret it. وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. The messenger says to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh my Rabb, look at my people. They have actually not given that exact value and respect and fulfilling the rights of this Quran. They have actually discarded it. They have forgotten it. They have set it aside. This is a complaint of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, about those who put the Quran on the side. So we don't want him to complain to Allah about us. Therefore, it's important for us to read the Quran, try and perfect the recitation, learn its meaning, bit by bit, put it into practice. The days of joy and the days of all sorts of actions that we do and little pieces of play and amusement that we actually engage in, those days should not be within the transgression of Allah. And if we have passed in that way, there is always room to change and improve as time passes. We get closer and closer to Allah. That's what it's all about. So point number one that I've raised this evening is to develop your connection with Allah, with the revelation that Allah has sent. Allah sends this revelation. One of the biggest regrets that man would have on the day of judgment is Allah sent you a message and you didn't bother looking at what that message was. Imagine your whole purpose of creation encapsulated in a book and you haven't bothered looking at that book. What a waste. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us from those. The second matter, the issue of company, the issue of your friends. the issue of those around you is raised very powerfully in this surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about those who will regret on the day of judgment. They will regret their company, the people they had around them. Those who are around you, they either encourage you to do good or they encourage you to do bad. They may be discouraging you from good, or if they were good people, they would discourage you from bad. You need to ask yourself two questions. What type of friends do I have? What type of people do I interact with? That is question number one. Question number two is, what type of a friend am I to those whom I interact with? So these are two pertinent questions. Am I a good friend? Do I remind people about what's right and wrong? Do I remind people about their duty unto Allah slowly but surely, without attacking them, without hurting, harming, but in a nice way putting forward what is correct and what would please Allah? Or am I a person who leads them astray after they actually knew the path? And this is why one of the verses Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the person who has wronged himself and he is in regret, he will say, يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. He will say, oh, I wish I did not have so and so as my friend. This person led me astray after the truth came to me. After Allah had guided me, then this person led me astray. And Allah says, indeed, shaitan is a big deceiver. So these are the two messages that I wanted to mention this evening. When the verses were recited, I thought of it immediately. We must make mention of this surah, the regrets that man would have on the day of judgment. There are a lot, but primarily regretting lack of connection with the revelation, and secondly, regretting friends that you have or have had. A lot of the times when you have bad friends, they actually slow you down and you don't achieve what you want to achieve. Even if it's just a school or a university, when those around you are not studious, when those around you are not serious, you actually do not perform and you don't fulfill the way you would have had you been with good friends. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. The last thing I'd like to mention before I close, this surah is called the criterion, Al-Furqan. One of the secrets, or it's not actually a secret, but one of the opinions is that when you adopt what Allah has instructed you to adopt, He automatically gives you the ability to distinguish between right and wrong, between the darkness and light. Automatically, when someone speaks, you know, within you can tell what's wrong with the speech, because you know Allah's given you this little sixth sense and ability because of your closeness to Allah. When you are serious about your closeness to Allah, Allah gives you the ability to distinguish. In another verse in Surah Al-Anfal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا. O you who believe, if you develop the proper relationship with Allah, if you develop your consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will definitely be granted from Him the ability to distinguish. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only grant us the ability to distinguish, but the ability to follow up thereafter in the right way. May Allah bless you all. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.